Greetings and salutations. Thank you for lending an ear to The Voice of the Times this Saturday, May 22, 2021. For today's editorial, brand agnostic vaccine policy, one of DOH's better decisions. The Department of Health, or DOH, this week announced that it would implement what it calls a brand-agnostic vaccine policy. That is, it will no longer advertise the brands of vaccines being made available at government vaccination centers. This is one of the more sensible decisions the DOH has made with respect to the country's problematic vaccine rollout and is most welcome, even if a bit overdue. The circumstances that led the DOH to make the announcement are a perfect illustration of why the policy is needed. Several vaccination sites in Metro Manila were overwhelmed by large crowds when information spread that these were distributing the vaccine manufactured by Pfizer. This created an obvious and somewhat ironic increased risk of infection for the people hoping to receive vaccinations. President Duterte, on hearing of the situation, ordered the DOH to correct it, which resulted in the new policy. Several local government officials, most notably Quezon City Mayor Josefina Joy Belmonte, whose city has the largest network of vaccination sites, expressed support for the DOH policy. Unfortunately, in the Senate, which as a collective during the current legislative session has displayed a remarkable talent for finding and clinging to positions that are as far from common sense and public benefit as possible, dissent against the DOH policy was quickly raised. Senator Maria Josefa Imelda Aimee Marcos complained, "Informed consent is the least we can give Filipino patients. They are vaccinated, fully aware of the risks as well as the benefits involved. How can they even sign a consent form if they don't know the brand they had?" Her sentiments were echoed by Senators Ana Theresia Riza Oliveros, Francis Kiko Pangilinan, and Maria Lourdes Nancy Binay, all of whom insisted that vaccine recipients must be given a choice of their preferred vaccine, with Oliveros opining that the new policy was counterproductive and could further erode the people's trust in the government's vaccination program. Had any of the senators prioritized informing themselves of the details of the policy ahead of misinforming the public about it for the sake of media exposure on a slow news day, they might still disagree with it, but might at least raise arguments that were not so predictably facile and specious. The policy only stops the practice of announcing what type of vaccine is available at any particular vaccination center, and informed consent will not be diminished at all. Patients will still be given complete information about what product they are receiving and have the opportunity to decline it based on that once they arrive at the site. To do as the senators are suggesting will happen, giving people mystery vaccines, would not only be a violation of basic medical ethics, but common sense, as the information would be needed in case the patient needs follow-up attention due to an unexpected reaction or other unrelated medical concerns. The reality is that all of the vaccines currently available in the Philippines, which have all been approved for emergency use based on clear and uniformly applied medical guidelines, are practically indistinguishable in terms of overall effectiveness and possible side effects on patients. The oft-repeated advice of public health experts that people should take any vaccine available to them is sound and should be followed. Vaccine skepticism or vaccine hesitancy has become a grave problem and the biggest obstacle to the government's effort to oversee the vaccination program, and it is caused primarily by the spread of misinformation. We certainly do not believe any of the dissenting senators are intentionally seeking to undermine the vaccination effort, but their statements unfortunately have the same effect. Not for the first time, we urge the senators and all public officials whose word carries the weight of added credibility due to their positions to be more responsible and circumspect in their comments, particularly on subjects known to be outside their areas of expertise. And that's the editorial for Saturday, May 22, 2021. For more news and information, get a copy of the Manila Times on print, subscribe to our digital edition, or log on to www.manilatimes.net. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, and listen to The Voice of the Times.